But now it's time for a little inspiration to help you stick to those fitness New Year's resolutions. I am joined by a woman who is the host of a show called Woman vs. Workout on YouTube's 3V channel. She takes on crazy exercises from backflips on skis to training with the Fire Department of New York. She most recently was the first woman to complete the Extreme SEAL experience, and she's held a successful career as a fitness model in Europe, Australia, South Africa, Indonesia, and Turkey. Lauren Berlingeri. Hi, Lauren. How are you today?
I'm doing great, Brynn. And yourself?
I'm great, and thank you for coming on the program. So before we get into talking about ways to get rid of that holiday bulge from overeating, you recently did the Extreme SEAL experience. So what was that like?
The Extreme SEAL experience was something I've never experienced before in my life. I mean, it was by far one of the toughest things I've done, and I'm also the first woman to ever complete this course. So, I mean, there was some great achievements in it, and, you know, there was some really physically challenging parts of the whole experience, but I really had to dig deep, and I believe it was the mental aspect that really helped me get through the whole course itself. So, I mean, it was truly amazing.
So what kinds of things are included in the Extreme SEAL experience?
I mean, it was 24 hours. So we pretty much didn't sleep through the whole night, and from the moment we started to the moment we end, we did not stop moving. It was pure physical exercise. There was a whole mental component. They try to break you down. We did everything from running, swimming, to push-ups, to sit-ups, to chin-ups. We did log PT, where I was holding a log over my head for as long as I possibly could. We had a whole mission at the end of the day where we literally had to capture a pilot, and there was so many different elements to it, and there was so much that we packed in 24 hours that I was exhausted for weeks after.
Well, congratulations on completing that. And how did you decide that you wanted to end up accomplishing this?
I mean, I want to accomplish everything that I start, definitely. I don't think I would start anything without the idea or the notion in the back of my head to accomplish it. I definitely didn't allow myself the option of ever giving up, which I do with most things, you know. I didn't think about it. I just wanted to push through, and I definitely had a great team of guys around me that were really supportive, and they really wanted to see me succeed as well. So, I mean, it was just truly an amazing experience.
Well, how can anyone listening transfer the motivation that you had for completing something as tough as the Extreme SEAL experience into just watching their weight and watching what they eat this holiday season?
I mean, there's many different things that you could do. Again, I want to say that mentally, if you have the right state of mind and you believe you can do it, you will accomplish anything because you don't give yourself the option. Second, that you have regret or that you feel like you're going to disappoint or you feel you don't have enough worth in order to complete it is the second you start believing it, and then that's when it becomes a reality. I really truly believe that if you don't give yourself the option and you set up good intentions for yourself for the day, and you're present in the moment, and you say, you know what, I'm not going to eat that and I'm not going to overdrink because I want it, then you will achieve it. You know, it's the second that you doubt yourself that you end up falling off track. So definitely give yourself a few minutes at the very beginning of the day and set up your intentions. What do you want? What are your goals? And give yourself no option but to succeed.
And I imagine that helps a lot, especially with everyone stressing out with everything they have to get done. A lot of people are probably thinking, oh, I don't have time for the gym right now.
Yeah, and I mean, you don't have to go to the gym in order to work out, you know. There's many different things that you could do. You could go for a walk. We all know the basics, push-ups, sit-ups. There's basic stretchings that you could do in your house. Just taking that time to remove yourself from that stress, breathing, you know, doing the breathing exercises, or just taking yourself and removing yourself from your situation and the stress will enable you to make smarter decisions for the rest of the day. I really, like, am a true believer of that. So even if you don't have an hour to work out, do 5 minutes, do 10 minutes. I promise you, you'll leave feeling better than when you started.
So if we happen to go to a holiday party and we do end up eating a little too much, what are some things that maybe we could do the next day just so that way we get back on track?
Yeah, I mean, that's a great question. What I do the next day is I usually have myself a green juice. Green juices for me are unbelievable because when I'm feeling a little bit hungover from the day before or a little bit too full where I don't want to eat anything more, but yet I'm feeling, you know, my blood sugar level going down and I feel like the cravings coming back, the green juices really start me on a good kick. Like, they're so full of minerals and vitamins, and there's great digestive enzymes in there, and it's raw and it's alive, and it just gives you that same feeling. You become alive, and it's so alkalining. So there's so many great reasons why I truly believe that juices kind of give you that kick that you'll need to set up the rest of your day on a good positive track.
Now, what kinds of things make up a green juice, especially for those people who maybe this is a new term for them?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's a great question. Green juices are anything pretty much that are really green. And the darker the green, the more rich it is with phytonutrients that it has packed in it. So kale, spinach, Swiss chard, celery, cucumber, parsley, coriander, mint. There's so many different things. As you see in the grocery store, they're all green. Then you can put some lemon and lime in there. Put a green apple in for a little bit of sweetness, and you are ready to go. You're going to have yourself something that's so packed full of phytonutrients that you will be alive.
And I feel like that's something that can really help to energize you, especially for those people who maybe they need to take a whole day out for their holiday shopping. That's something that won't have them dragging by the end of the day.
Exactly. Instead of having a coffee, which is usually just a kick that you get for a few hours and then you crash, this gives you a sustainable amount of energy to get through your day. You literally feel alive because it is alive. And I really am a strong believer that you are what you eat or you are what you drink. And, you know, try it out. There's many different stores and places that you can grab them at grocery stores. They're all over the place. It's definitely maybe a new term to some people, but I really believe that it's going to be everywhere because it's changed my life, and I think that it will be able to change a lot of other people's lives as well.
Now, what kinds of things can people expect to see on your Woman Versus Workout series, especially for the holiday season?
Well, we're doing many different cool things. One of the newest episodes that's coming out is NASCAR. I got to drive a stock car. I was literally going at speeds of 130 miles per hour. I mean, you can check out some of the previous episodes as well. I did firefighter training. I did tough mudder. I did a backflip on skis. I did extreme wakeboarding, big wave surfing. Like, this show is so exciting and fun, and it's just giving a new spin on exercising and fitness itself. Go out, be adventurous, try new things. You know, I promise you, it's much more exciting than, you know, your average day at the gym.
And it sounds like you are really a true inspiration to a lot of women, and I'm sure even a lot of men out there for wanting to get in shape.
I hope so. I mean, I find it's changed my life altogether. So if I could give you some of the keys that has led me to such success and just feeling so good in my life, I just really wish I could share it and share my experiences with everybody else. And I'm glad to hear that I'm inspiring people.
Now, can we just go to YouTube and type in Woman Versus Workout and we'll be able to easily find your videos, or is there an easier way to get to them?
There is an easier way to get to it. It's youtube.com/3V. And you can type in Woman Versus Workout. You can follow me on my website, womanversusworkout.com, and also Twitter, which is Laza Berlingeri, which is Laza Berlingeri, and again, my website, laurenberlingeri.com.
Sounds great. Well, thank you for coming on the program, Lauren. It's been a pleasure talking with you.
Thank you so much, Brynn.
Have a great day. That was Lauren Berlingeri. She is the host of Woman Versus Workout on YouTube's 3V channel, which she takes crazy exercises from going and doing backflips on skis to complete being the first woman to complete the Extreme SEAL experience, as well as training with the Fire Department of New York.